There was
Johnny McAdoo and McGee and me, and a couple or two or three went on the spree one day. We had a bop or two, which we knew how to blue, and the beer and whiskey flew, and we all felt gay. We visited McCann's, McLaman's, Humpty Dance. We then went into Swan's, our stomachs were to pack. We ordered out a feed, which indeed we did need, and we finished it with speed, but we still felt slack. Johnny McAdoo turned red, white and blue, and a plate of Irish stew he soon put out of sight. He shouted out in core with a roar for some more that he never felt before, such a keen appetite. He ordered eggs and ham, bread and jam, what a cram. For him we couldn't ram, though we tried our level best. For everything we brought, cold or hot, hot or not, it went down him like a shot, but he still stood the test. He swallowed tripe and lard, be the yard we discard. We thought it would go hard when the waiter brought the bill. We told him take your more, but he swore he would lord twice as much again and more before he had his fill. He nearly sucked the throb full of rot, says McGrath. He'll devour the tablecloth if you don't hold him in. When the waiter brought the charge, McAdoo felt so large. He began to scowl and barge, and his blood went on fire. He began to curse and swear, tear his hair in despair, and to finish the affair, call the shopman a liar. Shopman he threw out, and no doubt he did lout. McAdoo he kicked about like an old football. Tatted all his clothes, broke his nose, I suppose. He killed him with a few blows in no time at all. McAdoo began to howl and to growl, by his howl. Threw an empty bowl at the shopkeeper's head. Struck the Mickey Finn, peeled the skin off his chin, and the ruction did begin, and we all fought and bled. Peeler did a right man alive for a fight. Just to pay the drive for a sort of match away. Paid for all the bacon we ate for the trade. And went home to reminisce on the spree that day.